How's it going, everyone? And welcome to another Flesh and Blood video here on Channel Fireball. My name is Kel, also known as Red Zone Rogue, and today we're going to go over a Prism Sculptor of Arclight Classic Constructed deck. Prism is a very strong and popular hero, and she's only 2 points away from achieving Living Legend status. So this is kind of like her last hurrah as a hero in Classic Constructed. So I figured let's do her some honor and talk about her most recent version of the deck. It's a lot of fun. It's one of my favorite decks. If you didn't know out there, Prism is one of my favorite heroes in the entire game. I think Illusionist might be my second favorite class after Ranger. A Ranger diehard, love Lexi and Azalea, but I also really, really love Prism and Dromai. So let's talk about that. I'm gonna assume you know a decent amount of stuff already, but we will be going over every single card. And like I said, my name is Kel, also known as Red Zone Rogue, as the playmat does say. If you'd like to pick up this beautiful playmat, it's available on my own site, redzonerogue.com, as well as some other playmats and Flesh and Blood style stuff. Anyway, Prism, so standard stuff, 40 life, 4 intellect. She has a once per turn instant. For 2 resources, you can banish something from her soul and then create a spectral shield token. And we're gonna be making a lot of these spectral shield tokens. It's just an illusionist token aura and just sits around on the field. And it says, if your hero would be dealt damage, instead destroy the spectral shield and prevent one of that damage. So it just, you know, it's kind of a shield. But with our weapon, the Luminaris, we can also attack with them a lot. So the Luminaris is one of the best cards in the entire deck. It says, during your action phase, illusionist auras you control are weapons with 1 attack and once per turn action, 0 attack. And then while there is a yellow color strip card in our pitch zone, all illusionist attacks we control have go again, which include all of our spectral shield. So we can always attack for 1 with these. It's like death by 1,000 cuts, but those are not the only auras in the deck. No, no, no. We have this giant chunk right here that are auras or create auras. This is kind of like how Prism functions these days on the Classic Constructed level. You have a boatload of auras, and these just kind of sit around on the field and be really annoying for your opponent. And you just try to get ahead just in sheer quantities and chip them away with these. And when you find an opening, you can smash for big damage with one of these really powerful illusionist cards. That's kind of how the deck functions. It also has some pretty good defensive capabilities, but that's kind of the nutshell, right? You want to play a bunch of auras, just build up an army of auras, and then be fairly defensive, maintain your auras as much as you can, smash in when you can, and just kind of chip them down. It's like a battle of attrition, and Prism is very, very good at it. And she looks fabulous while she does so. So that's Prism and Luminaris. We have a pretty standard equipment loadout here. We have Arcanite Skullcap for defensive value, just a really good defensive card. We have the Fiendel's Spring Tunic. This is actually great in the deck because we want to go long, so we'll get more resources out of the tunic than, you know, your standard aggro decks, because we're not really an aggro deck. We're like mid-range control. Ironhide Gauntlet. We actually don't have a lot of arm options, and this is just a pretty good defensive one. And then we have, of course, the beautiful Phantasmal Footsteps. It's really good at protecting our action points, basically, when our opponent wants to pop one of our Phantasm cards. Blocking with a card with attack 6 or more will destroy our Phantasm card. It won't do any damage, and then our turn is over. But if we have these footsteps ready and willing, we can pay some resources and get our action point back, which is really, really good. We can also defend with them if we want to pay some resources, but we got to be careful that we don't defend anything with attack 6 or more, or they'll break our boots. We don't want to break our boots. We also have a couple other options here. Crown Reflection, Null Rune Gloves, and the new Silent Stilettos. The Stilettos work as kind of like a one-shot Phantasmal Footsteps, but they more importantly have Arcane Barrier, just like the Crown of Reflection has Arcane Barrier and Null Rune Gloves. So against Wizards, for example, Icelander, Kano, we're gonna be bringing these in for that Arcane Barrier. The Crown of Reflection is pretty interesting. It does some shenanigans with our auras, but for the most part, we bring it in for the Arcane Barrier. And that's gonna be it for the equipment loadout. Let's talk about the auras first, because they're a big chunk of the deck, and it's really what makes this deck different when you compare it to other Flesh and Blood decks. So here we have Prismatic Shield. This is just a 3-drop instant that creates 3 Spectral Shield tokens. So it just swarms the board. It's a great card against many, many different decks. We're only running 2 of them because it can be a little slow at cost 3. And I mean, it's just a bunch of Spectral Shields, but they're a good way to do some damage and chip on in. So I do like the Prismatic Shield. Next we have the Shimmers of Silver, incredibly powerful card. We got a nice, really, really sweet of powerful generic illusionist cards in Everfest, like this chunk, and we got more here. Everfest was very, very kind to Prism, let's just say. So Shimmers is a 0-drop action. All of these, by the way, all of the generic ones are 0-drop actions, and all of the light illusionist ones are 4-drop instant auras. We can play these ones at instant speed. These ones we cannot. So keep that in mind. I'm not gonna reiterate it here, but just keep it in mind. So 0-drop has a once per turn effect. Whenever we attack with an illusionist or a weapon, put a +1 counter on it, which is great because those counters stick around. And then it also has Spectra. So Spectra is an interesting mechanic. All of these, I believe, have Spectra on them, and that's how your opponent is going to destroy them. It says, Spectra, this card can be attacked. When Shimmers of Silver becomes the target of an attack, destroy it and close the combat chain. The attack does not resolve. So it doesn't trigger any on-hit effects or anything like that. It just blows it up no matter what. Your opponent's basically going to have to do that to clear out all of these, because they're good. They're very, very good. So this one just puts little +1 counters on all of our auras that we can attack with. And because of Luminarist, during our action phase, illusionist auras are weapons with 1 attack. So all of our auras are weapons. Therefore, anytime we attack with them, they get a +1 counter, which is great. It's usually good to kind of spread the love a little bit, especially if you're putting them on the Spectra auras. You don't want to stack them up too much because your opponent will target that one first. It's also good to put them on the weaker ones, effect wise, so your opponent has to, you know, decide between, do I want to get rid of the strong attack aura or the strong effect aura. Usually the strong effect aura is the right choice here, but still. Next up we have Haze Bending. This is another great one. Once per turn effect, whenever Haze Bending or another illusionist token aura you control is destroyed, create a Spectral Shield. So it's just kind of like an insurance policy. Anytime they destroy any of our stuff, we get a Spectral Shield. Really, really good. Next, we also have Pierce Reality. This is a big heavy hitter. It's a 0-drop. The first illusionist attack action card we play each turn has +2, which is really good for some of the ones in here we'll talk about. And we're running 3 of these. We're running 3 of all these, by the way. You just run all of them. We have Passing Mirage, another one with beautiful artwork. Your first illusionist attack each turn loses and can't gain Phantasm. Really, really good with some specific ones that we'll talk about. Once again, the Herald of Erudition comes to mind. Now we have our light illusionist auras. Like I said, these are all instants and they all cost 4. So they're pretty hefty to play, but they're very strong. This is Ode to Wrath. Well, by the way, they all have Spectra. All of these have Spectra. When a source you control deals damage to an opposing hero, they lose 1 health. So basically it does an extra damage to them, but it's a loss of health. So it's not like arcane damage or anything. They can't prevent it. And it just says illusionist attack action cards you control have go again, which is great. It's good if you don't have anything to pitch for Luminaris to give him all your attacks go again if you have a yellow color strip. And also for Luminaris, you can't just pitch for no reason. So you have to have a reason to actually pitch to activate the Luminaris. So Ode to Wrath giving them all go again is pretty good. Then we also have Parable of Humility. This one says attack action cards controlled by opposing hero have -1 attack while attacking and defending. So it makes it more difficult for your opponent to hit you, but it also makes it more difficult for them to pop your phantasms because they have to have an attack of 6 or higher. So just a 6 attack would not cut the mustard if you have a parable out because it would get -1 and go to 5. So just really good, just an annoying one. This one can do a ton of damage. This is Merciful Retribution. It says whenever an aura or an attack action you control is destroyed, like by Phantasm, deal 1 arcane damage to target hero. So that is arcane damage. So if they have arcane barrier, they can prevent it. If it's a non-token light card, put it into your hero's soul, which is great. So we can get, you know, cards into Prism's soul to make more Spectral Shields. So just really great. And just having all of these out on the field is a nightmare for everyone. And then last but certainly not least, we have Genesis. This one is one that you would like to have sit around for a while, but your opponent's probably gonna kill it as soon as possible. At the start of your turn, you may put a card from your hand into your hero's soul. If it's an illusionist card, create a Spectral Shield. If it's a light card, draw a card. So if it's a light illusionist card, you get to create a Spectral Shield and draw a card, and then you have that card in Prism's soul. This card's amazing. Kill on sight. This is a kill on sight cards. And so that is all of your auras. These are very strong, very, very good. I mean, you mostly run all of them, but sometimes you'll side them out in certain matchups. So if your opponent's, you know, running like Icelander or something like that, then Parable of Humility loses a little bit of value. Same thing with Passing Mirage. So depending on the matchup, you can side some out, but for the most part, you're gonna be running most of them. And I almost never cut the Genesis. Let's talk about just some of our big illusionist attacks, starting with Miraging Metamorph. This is a 1/7, blocks for 3. This has Phantasm. We'll go over Phantasm once, but then, you know, all these other attacks have Phantasm, so we're not going to go over it every single time. Phantasm just says, when it is defended by a non-illusionist attack action card with 6 or more attack, destroy it and close the combat chain, which is why you want those cards that get rid of Phantasm or reduce the attack of your opponent's blocking cards. This one's actually just fantastic because it's a 1/7, and if it's destroyed, you get to create a token that's a copy of any aura you control. Like maybe you want another Genesis or something, which is good. It's really good. So we technically run 3 of these in the deck. I currently have one of them in a Dromai deck because I don't own 5 of them, but you will be running 3 of these. We have Fractal Replication, just a single Fractal Replication. I like this card a lot, but it's very situational. It's a 0 drop, star, star. When you play or defend with Fractal Replication, it gains the abilities and effects of all illusionist attack action cards on the combat chain. Its attack is equal to the greatest base attack among all illusionist attack action cards on the combat chain, and is the same is true for the defense. So this is really, really good with something like Herald of Erudition, where you can do Herald of Erudition and then just slam down a Fractal for another Herald, which is really, really good. But it's a little situational in that if you don't have a good one to play, or if this is your only attack, then it does nothing. So you kind of want to avoid cards that have that do stone nothing. Herald of Erudition is nuts. It's a 2/5. It has Dominate, and if it hits, it goes into your soul and you get to draw 2 cards. So yeah, you want to hit with this one. This is the one you want to hit with. You can have insane turns because these will all have go again from your Luminaris. So 5, Dominate, go again, and if it hits, you get to draw 2 cards. It's disgusting. So this is one of the ones that you definitely want to, you know, make sure you can get around that Phantasm. So absolutely fantastic card. We have Wartune Herald. It's a very simple card. It's just a 1/6 Phantasm, and if it hits, put it into a hero's soul. Just a really good aggressive one to come on in when you have time to do so. We also have the blue one, which is a 1/5, same kind of deal. The blues have a little less value than the yellows, in my opinion, because the yellows activate your Luminaris to give everything go again, but blues are good for resources. We have Herald of Protection, which is a great one for generating Spectral Shields. It's a 2/6 Phantasm, and if it hits, it goes into your hero's soul and you get to create a Spectral Shield token, which is pretty good. So we run the yellows, and we also run the blues, which is 2/5 with the same ability. And then finally, for our illusionist attacks, we have the Herald of Triumph, which is a 2/6. And it says, attack action cards have -1 attack while defending Herald of Triumph. And if it hits, it goes into your hero's soul. So it's just a big beater and also gives all attacks minus. So it's just really hard to pop, which is really good. So we run the yellows and we run the blues. Next up, let's talk about our other attacks that we have. And these ones are a little more situational and also a little more defensive in some ways. I'm gonna take this Oasis Respite and stick it here. But we have Command and Conquer. So this is not a card that you include all the time in your deck. It's really good against heroes like Icelander. It's really good against opposing illusionists because it's really good at popping their attacks. It's also good against rangers. It's not something you put in all the time, but well, when you do, it's pretty good. So we have two of them. It's more of like a, like I said, like a sideboard card. Celestial Cataclysm can be really good as well. I put it in most matchups, but sometimes it doesn't make it in there. It's a 0/7, and as an additional cost to play Celestial Cataclysm, I can banish 3 cards from my hero's soul and then go again. This is pretty good if I don't think my opponent's going to have a lot of defense reactions, because if they're just going to be able to unmovable this, you feel real sad. You feel really sad. But if you don't think they can do that, this can be a beating. We also run the new card, Fiendal's Fighting Spirit. This is actually great. So this is a 3/6, but we almost never really play it unless we're in like a really good position, let me say that. But it says when you attack or defend with it, if you have less life than an opposing hero, you gain a life, which is great. So this is a card you can block with, gain some life. We still have, you know, our spectral shields sitting around because they can also help prevent some damage here. So it's just a really nice card. Blocks well. If we need to attack with it, it attacks well. It's great for opposing illusionists because it has 6 attack. It has the yellow color strip. Just an all-around great card for this deck. All right, now we have our giant chunk of defensive cards. Let's start off with Oasis Respite. I love this card. I think this card's amazing. So it's a 1 cost instant. Prevent the next 4 damage that would be dealt to target hero by a source of your choice. If they have less life than each other hero, they gain a life. I love that it just prevents damage straight up. It's really good against arcane damage classes like Wizard and Kano and Icelander. It's also really good against heroes that do a lot of dominate attacks because it's an instant. So I like it against Bravo. A little bit Oldham too. I like it against the Wizards. Against some of the little chippy, you know, Death by a Thousand Cuts heroes like Fi. Not as much. Arclight Sentinel is great against any class that attacks you, basically. It costs 6, but it basically gives you a free turn. So it says, it's a Prism Specialization. If Arclight Sentinel is in the arena when an opponent announces an attack, they have to choose Arclight Sentinel as the target of the attack, and it has Spectra, which means when they attack it, and this becomes the target of the attack, this gets destroyed, and the combat chain closes, and the attack does not resolve. So basically, before they can attack you, since it's an instant, you can just be like, okay, I'm jamming down the Arclight Sentinel. Come at me. Your turn's over. It's a great way to just end the turn here. Not very good against the Wizards, but against almost everything else, it is quite good. Next, we have Sink Below. This is a classic, just a 0/4 defense reaction, and it also lets you put a card from your hand to the bottom and then draw a card. It's really good. Once again, not good against Wizards, but against everything else, it's quite good. That All You Got is especially good against a lot of the aggro decks out these days. This is a 0/3 defense reaction. It's a yellow pitch card too, so it activates Luminaris if we pitch it. And it says, while this is defending an attack with 2 or less attack when the combat chain closes, you get a draw card. I love this against the ninjas. It's really sweet. So we are running 2 That All You Got. And then finally, to round it off, we have a full playset of Soul Shield. It's just a 2/6 defense reaction, and then it goes into our hero's soul when the combat chain closes. Just a really, really solid defense reaction. Mostly good against big go tall decks. Not as good against some of the ninja-y kind of stuff, but it's still really good. So we have defensive options. We basically want to just swarm the board with our auras, backed up occasionally by our big attacks, Miraging Metamorph. But we really want to get in with like these heralds and that kind of stuff. But a lot of the time you can be very comfortable just blocking it out, playing more defensive, and then chipping away with your spectral shields and your army of auras. And that is the deck tech. I personally really, really love Prism, and I'll be sad to see her go when she gets Living Legend out, which is probably going to happen very, very soon, but she'll always be available for play in Blitz until she's not, and in Commoner and Ultimate Pit Fight. Everything's legal in Ultimate Pit Fight, so worst comes to worst, you can always play Prism in UPF. Thanks for watching, everyone. Let me know what you think in the comments down below, and we'll see you next time.